Good morning, Grade 7. Hope you are all doing well and being safe. This is Ms. Pamela Tini giving the physics course. Today we are going to do the last section in Chapter 5. Section 4, Energy and Fossil Fuels. So please open your books on page 166 and follow up with me. What are fossil fuels? A fuel is a material that contains stored potential energy. Fossil fuels are fuels made from material that formed hundreds of millions of years ago, for example, coal, petroleum, and natural gas. So in a general definition, a fuel is a material that contains stored potential energy. However, fossil fuels are specific kinds of fuels that are made from material that formed hundreds of millions of years ago. But how is that even possible? How can we use materials today that are made from materials formed hundreds of millions of years ago? So how do fossil fuels form? When plants and animals in ancient forests died back in time, their remains piled up in thick layers. Where did they pile up? In swamps and marshes. Then clay and sand sediments covered these remains, and the resulting pressure and high temperature turned the remains into fossil fuels. So fossil fuels that we use today are made from the remains of plants and animals that died in ancient forests hundreds of millions of years ago. Now look at the figure in front of you. This figure shows how coal was formed, which is a kind of fossil fuels. First look at the left. It shows that we have, before the dinosaurs, many giant plants died in swamps. So these plants are in a swamp 300 million years ago. Then look at the middle. Over millions of years, the plants were buried under water and dirt. Then, finally, heat and pressure turned the dead plants into coal. So the coal that we use today is made from the remains of plants that lived 300 million years ago in swamps. And then they were covered by layers of water and dirt, and the high pressure and heat turned the remains of these plants into fossil fuels. The second figure shows petroleum and natural gas formation, which are the other two kinds of fossil fuels. So first, look at the left. Tiny marine plants and animals died and were buried on the ocean floor. Over time, the marine plants and animals were covered by layers of silt and sand. Then look at the middle. Over millions of years, the remains were buried deeper and deeper. The enormous heat and pressure turned the remains into oil and natural gas. Today, we drill down through layers of sand, silt, and rock to reach the rock formations that contain oil and natural gas deposits. So this is why we drill in order to find these fossil fuels, because they are covered by layers and layers of sand, silt, dirt, and water, and they are made of animals and plants that died millions of years ago. Remember that energy is conserved, and we stated that and explained it in the previous session. Energy is neither created nor destroyed. This means that fossil fuels do not create energy, but they contain energy. Where did it come from? Fossil fuels contain energy that came from the sun. How? Look at the figure in front of you. The sun produces light energy. Plants turn this light energy into chemical energy that is stored inside of them. These plants that were here hundreds of millions of years ago were buried under thick layers of sand and silt and water, as we already explained, and turned into fossil fuels that we use in order to take energy. So this is what we mean when we say that fossil fuels contain energy that came from the sun, because plants contain energy that comes from the sun, and fossil fuels are made of ancient plants. Now I'm going to talk about energy transformations in the formation and the use of fossil fuels. This is very important and it contains several steps. So please concentrate with me. The first step is in the sun. So as we already stated, the fossil fuels contain energy that comes from the sun. The sun transforms nuclear energy to electromagnetic energy. So nuclear reactions in the sun transform the nuclear energy into light energy, which is also called electromagnetic energy because light waves are electromagnetic waves. Then, in the second step, ancient plants and animals transform this electromagnetic energy from the sun to stored chemical energy, and their remains become coal. As we already explained, when these ancient plants and animals died, their remains were covered by layers and layers of sand, silt, and water, and because of the high pressure and temperature, they turned into fossil fuels. In this example, we are talking more specifically about coal. In the third step, coal is burned to make steam. This transforms chemical energy to thermal energy. So in these three steps, we have three energy transformations. The first is from nuclear to electromagnetic in the sun. The second is in ancient plants and animals. The transformation is from electromagnetic, which is light energy, into chemical energy. And the third is when coal is burned. It transforms the chemical energy that is stored in the ancient plants and animals into thermal energy, which is heat. In the fourth step, steam turns turbines, transforming thermal energy to mechanical energy. So as we already stated in the third step, when coal is burned, chemical energy is transformed into thermal energy. This thermal energy is transformed into mechanical energy when the steam turns turbines, which are like big fans. In the fifth step, these turbines spin electric generators, and thus it transforms this mechanical energy into electrical energy. And in the final step, we use this electrical energy in the devices at our homes or schools or whatever. So here they are giving a specific example, the hair dryer. The hair dryer transforms electrical energy to thermal energy, which is heat. So we have six energy transformations. The first is in the sun, from nuclear energy to electromagnetic energy. The second is the transformation by ancient plants and animals from electromagnetic energy into stored chemical energy. The third is when we burn the coal or the fossil fuel, we change the stored chemical energy into thermal energy. Then this thermal energy is used to produce mechanical energy in turbines, and these turbines are used to transform mechanical energy to electrical energy when they spin electric generators. And finally, the final transformation is by us at our homes or schools. It depends on how we use the electricity or the electrical energy that reaches us. So we may use it by hair dryer, we may use it by a toaster, by a washing machine, by a lamp. So the energy transformation depends on the device that we use. Note, fossil fuels can be burned to release the chemical energy stored millions of years ago. And this process is called combustion. So whenever we burn fossil fuels in order to release the energy stored inside of them millions of years ago, the process is called combustion. As a homework, please solve number 1, parts A, B, and C, and number 2, parts A and B, page 169. Your homeworks must be done and submitted to me on Thursday, April 23. Good luck and stay safe.